Hi, you guys. Happy Thursday. I just got to drive a wonderful family to their new home in the Valley, which is conveniently located in Wine Country. I haven't been that way since I was doing the wine tours in the summer last year, right before winter came and COVID came. I got a lot more memories of them tours probably than the people who are on my bus. They got all kinds of like farmers markets down there, like this where all the farms are that grow the vegetables and the fruits, right? So there's all kinds of stuff like that. And then I was thinking, oh, I should stop and get some fresh stuff, but my girlfriend's not here to cook for me. Right? So, you know, I'm not gonna just buy it to waste it. I'll wait till she comes back. Miss you, babe.
Okay, guys, I'm at the grocery store and I'm getting a grocery order. And I asked my boss four times, the lactose tolerant milk or intolerant or whatever it is, what percent do they want? What percent? You can have 0, 1, or down there, 3. She writes me back, the lactose free one.
Okay, guys. So, I just did this massive grocery order, right? Massive. And you know how good I'm not at getting groceries, right? Took me forever, right? I did have to get this girl to help me, and she was so lovely. But, you know, she believes she had purchased the biggest bag of cinnamon last week. So, I did ask her if I could follow her to her house. Maybe get a little Ziploc bag. No. I'm going to tell you a little something about the superstore epic failure of the lineup at the cash. So, everyone goes on one side. You're like perpendicular, if that's the right word, going this way, right? You're perpendicular to the aisles. You can't see down the aisle. Okay.
There's 1,000 people very slowly crossing this way, and there's a cop walking that way. So we're standing here trying to get people to go that way.
There's something nice to do that. That's nice. Listen, you ever need a ride, EJ's? We're the best. Coolest. And if you have a friend that needs an accessible vehicle,
that's
here we are.
Really good to know.
All right.
Have a good night.
Tell your friends. Is it a one way? That was awful lovely. Right? Just this random chick was standing in the middle of the street directing the traffic for people like me. Gotta be quick on your feet with your mask too. People coming up in your face. Oh yeah. Geez, there is a cop car down there. I think she sent me down a one way. Okay. Right? There's this guy and he's directing the grocery store lineup, right? So he got us all going down one direction. Right? So we're all standing there. Then he would take one at a time and put them in the lineup. Instead of going perpendicular, you're gonna go into the lineup and you're gonna be this way down the aisle. So Buddy puts me in the line. Two ladies butt right in front of me, knowing full well that's where I was going, right? And he goes, you can't cut in front of people. I said, just leave them there, right? And cause I'm thinking she's 9 months pregnant. Let me live. Buddy, let me live. Anyway, so all of a sudden, Buddy jumps on the cash because it's busy, which is a fabulous thing to do unless you are the coordinator of the lineup. As we are waiting down these aisles, where we originally started, which was way down here, which we can't see them, they can't see us, there's a lineup building. It's my lineup's turn to go. And a lady comes, and I'm like, the lineup starts back there. She goes, no, it doesn't. It starts there. So I look down, and that is the original line I was in, which has equally as many people. So now what? So lady believes it's 100% her turn. I said, no, there's a buddy. There's a buddy, he's gotta come and get you guys, right? Because I've been waiting already 2 lineups. Well, you know, she don't believe there's a buddy, right? Why would she? Because Buddy is now on the cash. He's not coming. I proceed to start loading my stuff on the cash, right? I don't know what in the hell the rest of them were doing. I'm thinking, please, the God, let something open up for that lady. ready, right? Because I know this is it for me. This is the end of me. Buddy closes down his cash and goes back to start manning the lineup. And I yell over, hey, hey, there's Buddy. I told you there was a Buddy. Her daughter was there and I said, look it, Buddy's there. And she just kind of gave a smile, right? And I said, no, no, your mother could have knocked me unconscious. Follow it up, Superstore. Buddy needs an assistant or a casual pull to pull from. You cannot take the man coordinating the lineup. Right, I finally get out there. I've been in that grocery store for a long time, right? Long. Anyway, I get to where I'm going to drop it off. It's an apartment building. Must have made 8 trips, right? Just to get them in the vestibule. So then, God love them, they come down to get the stuff. They come out, the door shuts, and they have locked themselves out of the building. We are now 3 in the vestibule and groceries. And they don't have to call anyone because they are new to the building. Anyway, I figured it out. I called the landlord and all I said was, hello, I've locked myself out of the building. You buzz me in. So I let them in, you know, told them I hope they like it here. Best job ever. Best job ever. I love you guys.